And I realize that you are the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. And I salute you on today, God, for your greatness and your majesty. Because you are everything that I desire. You are everything that I want, Father God. And I just want you to know that on today, Father God, that I love you, Lord. I'm asking you to answer these prayers and all others in your Son Jesus' name. Amen. Amen and amen. I thank God for Jesus on today. I thank God for Jesus on today. I just want to thank him. Because he is truly worthy of all the glory, the honor, and the praise. I just want to thank God on today. He been dealing with me about some things concerning our jobs as a pastor, as an elder, as a preacher, and as a teacher. The name of the sermon on today that he gave me is Your Soul Watcher. Oh God, I just want to thank you, God. I just want to thank you on today. We're going to start in the book of Ezekiel, chapter 3. We're going to start in the book of Ezekiel, chapter 3. I want to kind of give y'all some history and background on a man called Ezekiel. Ezekiel was a mighty man of God. Ezekiel was a trained priest, and in the midst of him being trained as a priest, God called him to be his prophet. Not only did the Lord call him to be his prophet, he told him some things about his job. He told him some things about what was required of him as a prophet. Ezekiel used to have visions and stuff like that. Him and Isaiah as a prophet, they was real close in the job that God mandated them. But Isaiah was the prophet crying out of things to come. And Ezekiel was a prophet crying out in the midst of the things that Isaiah said were to come. Ezekiel was a man of obedience. He was a man that was real stern and stalwart. And he was a man with outstanding strength and vigor in his body, mind, and in his spirit. And he was a man that even in the midst of pain, because his wife died during the time of his prophetic calling in God, he still was a man of obedience and a man that wanted to do just what God wanted him to do. Ezekiel was a man of purpose and a man of dignity in God. The Lord called Ezekiel to be his prophet during the time that Israel was captive by the Babylonian nations. I just want to give y'all a little bit of history about how God called Ezekiel. I want you to go to Ezekiel chapter 2, and I want you to read verses 1 through 10 concerning the man, the prophet, called Ezekiel. Read.
And he said unto me, Son of man, stand upon thy feet, and I will speak unto thee. And the Spirit entered into me when he spake unto me, and set me upon my feet, that I heard him that spake unto me. And he
see, sometimes God don't just speak to us. There's different ways that God can speak to us. He spoke to Ezekiel, not to speak to him verbally, but the Bible says that he entered into him. So that was a personal relationship. That was a relationship that got real intimate, because he wasn't just speaking to him as I'm speaking today. The Bible says that he entered into him, and then upon entering, he spoke to the man that he called Ezekiel. Read.
And he said unto me, Son of man, I send thee to the children of Israel.
Mandating him of his job. Read.
To a rebellious nation that hath rebelled against me.
To a hard-headed folk. Somebody who don't want to listen to their leader, who is God. Read.
They and their fathers have transgressed against me, even unto this very day.
The Bible says that they have did it in old and even new, because he said specifically the fathers and the sons. Read.
For they are impudent children and stiff-hearted. I do send thee unto them, and thou shalt say unto them, Thus saith the Lord God.
See, sometimes God will come to you and tell you what he wants you to say to certain people. He will say that you are going to say this and you are going to say that. And not just saying that, but you're going to say, Thus saith the Lord. Because it's not coming from me. It's not coming from him, her, their way. It's coming from God. Read.
And they, whether they will hear or whether they will forbid.
So whether they want to hear or whether they don't want to hear, it's your job if God calls you to tell them what thus said the Lord. Because it is said several times and will say as we go on and on that they are hard-headed. Read.
For they are a rebellious house, yet shall know that there have been a prophet among them.
Because a whole lot of folk is going to say you ain't who God say you is. But in the midst of you telling them what thus said the Lord, he says it's a surety that they're going to know that you were called by him. Read.
And thou, son of man, be not afraid of them.
Don't be scared. Read.
Neither be afraid of their words.
Because they're going to talk. It don't matter what they say. Read.
Though briars and thorns be with thee.
Let me tell you something. You can pick up a rose. And on the stem of that rose, you're going to see thorns in it. But then if you move away from the thorn and touch the other part of that stem, it still feel like it's sticky stuff on that pit. Those are called briars. So you're going to get some kind of feeling. You're going to feel some type of way with folk talking about you and looking at you a certain way and trying to degrade you or belittle you. You're going to feel some type of way. The book says so. Read the book.
And thou dost dwell among scorpions. Be not afraid.
And y'all already know scorpions got a poison venom inside of their tail. Their face look one way, but their tail is what carries the poison. So don't think not for now time that people ain't going to try to poison your ministry. They ain't going to try to put poison and say you this or say you that. Or they ain't going to try to say all kind of evil against you. The book says so. Read.
Be not afraid of their words.
Don't be scared.
Nor be dismayed at their looks.
Don't worry about how they're looking at you, because folks are looking at you funny. They do them all the time. They did it to me then and they're still doing it now. Read the book.
Though they be a rebellious house, and thou shalt speak my words unto them, whether they will hear or whether they will forbear. For they are most rebellious.
Hard-headed, but you still got to speak. Read.
But thou, son of man, hear what I say unto thee. Be not thou rebellious.
Don't you be hard-headed. Now, don't you be hard-headed. Now, God done already told you what to go say. He done already told you what to say, thus said the Lord to these people. And because you worried about how they look, or you worried about what they say, you don't want to do it. Because you still want to stay friends with this person. Or you still want this pastor to acknowledge you. Or you still want the bishop to call out your name. Don't you be hard-headed and not obedient to God. All because of the way somebody else is looking. Or the poison that they're trying to put upon you. Read.
Be not thou rebellious like that rebellious house. Open thy mouth.
Open your mouth and eat that I give. See, sometimes we don't want truth. We don't want to hear the truth. Sometimes when the Lord reveals certain things to us or tell us something, and let me go here first. Before God send you out there and have you say what thus said the Lord, he gonna get you straight first. He gonna tell you about you first. And you may not want to eat that whole roll. Skip all the way down to verse 10 in that very same chapter. And read that.
And he spread it before me, and it was written within and without, that there was written therein lamentations and mourning.
Did y'all hear what I say? The book says that there was mourning and lamentation. So it's something going on inside of God that he wants the people to know, because he's crying and he's crying and he's crying and he's crying. He's lamenting for the people because of their rebellion and because they have turned to wickedness instead of turning to God. So it's sorrowful inside of his heart. And so he called Ezekiel for to go and tell the people in the midst of their stuff. He allowed the Babylonians to cause Israel to be in captivity for a reason. Because of their rebellion. Because of their hard-headedness. Because of their stiffness. They didn't want to do what the Lord said. The Lord even said in the Bible that their fathers have rebelled against me. So he's talking about another generation. He's talking about another generation. So this is not nothing that just begun. I want you to go to Ezekiel chapter 3, read verses 1 through 10. Because we got to talk about him eating this stuff. I want to talk about him eating this stuff. See, because as a leader, and remember, the name of the sermon today is your soul watcher. So I'm giving you all this history and all this stuff because I need everybody to understand the job that is required of a leader. Read.
Moreover, he said unto me, son of man, eat that thou findest eat.
See, the Bible says, seek and you shall find. The Bible also says, study to show yourself approved. She just read a couple scriptures ago, and you may want to go back to 2 and 10, and read that again. What did it say was written?
And he spread it before me, and it was written within and without.
And without. So that means it was written on both sides. That means it was written on both sides. Finish that scripture.
And there was written therein lamentations. And mourning and woe.
And woes. Read.
Moreover, he said unto me, son of man, eat that thou findest, eat this roll, and go speak unto the house of Israel.
So sometimes you got to eat. Let me tell you something. Sometimes you got to swallow that pride that you got inside of you, and you got to, you know what, forget everything that everybody else said. I don't care if the pastor don't let me speak no more. I don't care if the bishop don't call my name no more. I don't care if they don't elevate me to where they think they want me to be. I don't care if they put me out the church. I don't care. I got to do what the Lord tell me to do because he clearly told me not to be rebellious against him. Rebellion is disobedience in anything that's contrary to the word of God. Read the book.
So I opened my mouth and he caused me to eat that roll. And he said unto me, son of man, cause thy belly to eat.
Now mind you, he didn't just tell him to eat it in his mouth. He says his belly. See, when we eat, it got to go down our esophagus, and then the acid gonna break it up, and then it's gonna go down inside of our stomach. When it get inside of our stomach, it's gonna cause some things to happen, right? It's gonna cause us to get nourished. It's gonna cause us to get fed. And if we eat too much of it, it's gonna cause us to get fat. Am I right? He wanted to get down in the bowels of your belly. Read.
Cause thy belly to eat and fill thy bowels with this roll that I give thee. Then did I eat it, and it was in my mouth as honey for sweetness.
Let me tell you something about the word of God. You keep on reading this book right here. It gets sweeter and sweeter the more you read it. Because not only is it going to correct you, in correcting you, it's going to feel good. And it's going to make you do right. And in doing right, you're going to be a sweet savor unto God. Are y'all listening to me?
Yes.
Read.
And he said unto me, Son of man, go, get thee unto the house of Israel, and speak with my words unto them.
My words, he said. Don't you go and add nothing, and don't you go and take nothing away. Speak my words that I tell you. Read.
For thou art not sent to a people of a strange speech and of a hard language, but to the house of Israel.
Correction starts in the house of God. Are y'all listening to me? So many people, oh, the sinner man is. You ain't got to worry about the sinner man. You better worry about your own self. You better worry about your own self and seeking your own soul salvation, that you can deliver your own soul from hell. Read.
Not too many people of a strange speech and of a hard language, whose words thou canst not understand. Surely, had I sent thee to them, they would have hearkened unto thee.
A prophet ain't honored in his own country. They could go somewhere else, and it'd be open arms. It'd be open arms because they are willing vessels to receive what the voice is saying to the church. What the spirit of the voice of God is saying to the church. They would be willing to, but if I'm in my own tribe, I was raised up in this church. Everybody know me. I go up in front of somebody and try to tell them what thus saith the Lord. Baby, they going to be one of them scorpions. Did you hear what I say? They going to be them briars and they going to be them thorns. Are y'all listening to me today? A prophet is not honored in his own country. Read the book.
But the house of Israel will not hearken unto thee. For they will not hearken unto me.
What makes me think that the folk don't listen to me and they don't even listen to God? But they've been in ministry for what, 30, 40 years? They've been in ministry what, for all their life? They done grew up inside the church. And you, me, him, her, they, women, all of us take these things personal. We take it personal. Oh, they did me like this. And oh, they did me like this. And they said this. And they said that. And they treat me like this. And they treat. And then we holler, oh, that church hurt me so bad. And oh, that church hurt. But the Bible already clearly told you, if you going as a voice for God, you're going to get some scorpions, baby. They're going to talk about you. They're going to do you like a dog. They're going to try to poison the ministry that God gave you. They're going to try to hold your past up over you. They're going to do all kind of matter of evil against you. All because you doing what thus said the Lord. Read the book.
For all the house of Israel are impudent and hard-hearted. Behold, I have made thy face strong against their faces.
Let me tell you something. If God called you, baby, he equipped you. You ain't got to worry about fear of nothing. You ain't got to worry, because what can man do to you? Psalms 118. Give me Psalms 118. Psalms 118 and 6. Read that scripture, that one scripture.
The Lord is on my side. I will not fear. What can man do to me?
What can man do to me? Man can't put you in heaven or hell. See, God, he got so much power, baby, he can blow and you can fall down. He can inhale and you can drop dead. Man can't do nothing to you. He said to Ezekiel, I have made your face, what? Read.
Strong against their faces and their forehead strong against their foreheads. As an adamant harder than the flint. Have I made thy forehead?
So it don't matter. It's like God got a shield around you. It's like he your bulwark, baby. He your battle axe. He got you hidden in that secret place. They can't do nothing to you. They can say whatever they want to say is part of carrying your cross. Don't ever forget that. They can do whatever they do is part of carrying your cross. It does not matter. You just don't be rebellious. Read.
Fear them not.
Fear them not, neither
be dismayed at their looks, though they be a rebellious house.
Did you hear what I say? And in the midst of you knowing that they're hard-headed and stiff-necked, you still got to do what the Lord tell you to do. But it's something else he wants you to do too. Read verse 10.
Moreover, he said unto me, son of man, all my words of height shall speak unto thee, receive in thy heart.
Did you hear that? Now what I'm giving you, I got to give you my own self. I know y'all have heard the saying, it comes to the receiver before they can give it. It comes to the messenger first. So I have to receive these things in my heart first before I can give it to somebody else. These things got to be embedded inside of me that I may not be walking in wickedness, that I may not be rebellious. See, these things got to be buried inside of my heart first. I'm the watchman. I got to walk circumspect and holy. I do. Read.
Moreover, he said unto me, son of man, all my words that I shall speak unto thee, receive in thine heart and hear with thy ears.
Are y'all listening? I got to receive it in my heart and within my ears. I don't just have to receive it in my heart, but I got to listen to what the voice is saying to the church. I have to listen. So that means that I got to stay in my prayer closet. That means I got to stay in the word of God. That means I got to seek his face more and more and more. Jump all the way down to verse 17. See, because it's a job that I have to do. And if I don't do it, I'm going to get in trouble. I'm going to get in trouble because, you know what? I want you to go to this verse. I want you to go to Ezekiel 33. Go to Ezekiel 33. Let's do Ezekiel 33. Let's go there first. Let's go there first. And I want you to start at the first verse. Because as a watchman, I got a job. And so everybody don't understand what their job is. They just want the title as a pastor, as a preacher, as a bishop, as anything. They just want some kind of title. But it is something required of the leaders. You understand what I'm saying? And see, we as leaders, we don't take it serious enough. That's why God got me speaking today. We don't take it serious enough. We don't have the fear of God anymore because we're so worried about titles and recognitions and acknowledgments and entertaining. It's not about entertaining. I want you to start at the first verse.
Again, the word of the Lord came unto me, saying, son of man, speak to the children of thy people and say unto them, when I bring the sword upon
a land. Okay, you know, back in those days, they had towers. They would have a brick gate, they called them gates, or bulwarks, around their cities. And it was really tall. And in each corner, east, west, north, and south, they had towers that they had people standing guard and watching to make sure that our war enemies would not come upon us unaware. Okay? Mm-hmm. So God is giving you an example right here. Mm-hmm. Read.
Son of man, speak to the children of thy people and say unto them, when I bring the sword upon a land, if the people of the land take a man of their coast and set him for their watchman.
That's the towers I was just telling you about. They have a certain amount of people up there in the towers watching to see if somebody trying to sneak in and attack. Read.
If when he seeth the sword come upon the land, he blow the trumpet and warn the people.
We the warning. We got to warn you. We are the warners. So if I see wickedness or misconduct or anything that's going on, and the Lord tell me to tell you this, I'm warning you. It ain't me. Because I really don't know what's going on in nobody's life. It ain't me. So if God tell me to come and tell you, why you mad at me? in secret. But the eyes of the Lord is in every place, beholding the good as well as the evil. It don't matter. It ain't no secrets with God. I've been telling y'all that all the time. I tell you that all the time. So if I see you headed for destruction, or I see that you are being attacked, I'm going to blow that trumpet. I'm going to tell you. Read.
Then whosoever heareth the sound of the trumpet and taketh not warning.
Now if you don't listen to that trumpet being blown, or you don't listen to what thus said the Lord, and I'm telling you, then what do the book say?
If the sword come and take him away, his blood shall be upon his own
head. It's your own fault that you go to hell. Because I know I already done talked to you. I done already done warned you. I done already done said what thus said the Lord. Now it's strictly and totally up to you to do or not to do. God gave us all free will. Read the book.
He heard the sound of the trumpet and took not warning. His blood shall be upon him. But he that taketh warning shall deliver his soul.
You're going to deliver your own soul from hell if you take the warning that God is telling you. You're delivering your own soul from hell. If he had me to come and warn you and tell you something, and you take heed, you're delivering your own soul from hell. Read the book.
But if the watchman see the sword come.
Now if I see destruction coming, or if I see the enemy is fixing to get ready to attack you, and I don't tell you, it's a consequence for that. Read.
And blow not the trumpet, and the people be not warned. If the sword come and take any person from among them, he is taken away in his iniquity, but his blood will I require at the watchman's
hand. It's my... Don't you know I get in trouble if I don't tell you? So you tell me, what sense do it make for me to get in trouble? All because I don't want to tell you. Why would I want to get in trouble because you're looking at me funny? Why I'm going to get in trouble because you're talking about me? Why I'm going to get in trouble because you putting poison in on the ministry that the Lord has given me? Are you kidding me? Do you actually think and believe that I want to go to hell all because I didn't tell you to keep you from going to hell? I'm not here trying to make no friends. I'm not here trying to hold nobody's hand. I'm going to lead you to the water, but it's up to you to drink. It's up to you to drink. That's why he made our face like a flint and hard as an adamant. Our foreheads, baby. We're not coming to pacify you. We ain't coming to hold your bottle. We're going to give it to you just like the Lord said, give it to you. Call me mean if you want to. It don't matter to me. I'm doing what thus said the Lord do. I'm not going to be hard-headed and rebellious. He told me not to be like you, him, her, thee, we, or us. Because we are all a sinner. The Bible says so. The Bible says so. But in order for me to give it to you, I got to get that thing down in my heart first. I'm not exempt. The Bible says so. We just read it. I'm not exempt. So I got to tell you what thus said the Lord. I got to give it to you, baby. And I got to give it to you straight. Because it's not going to just save you, but it's going to save me too. How about that? How about that? It's not going to save you, but it's going to save me too. Because if I don't, the Bible says that it's going to be required. And the blood going to be on my hands. Read verse 7. Read.
So thou, O son of man, I have set thee a watchman unto the house of Israel. Therefore thou shalt hear the word at my mouth, and warn them from me. When I say unto the wicked, O wicked man, thou shalt surely die.
Because the Lord will warn you, baby. He will send warning to you. If it ain't in a dream, it's in a vision. He'll even tell a little child. He'll use a donkey to warn you. You hear what I say? It don't matter. We got to stop being so hard-hearted, stiff-necked. and don't want to hear nothing from nobody, because can't nobody tell me nothing. I know the book. Yeah, if you know the book, and if you was applying it to the book, he would not have to send somebody else to tell you what you don't want to face. How about that? Read the book.
If thou dost not speak to warn the wicked from his way, that wicked man shall die in his iniquity, but his blood will I require at thine hand. Nevertheless, if thou warn the wicked of his way to turn from it, if he do not turn from his way, he shall die in his iniquity, but thou hast delivered thy soul.
Did y'all hear that? So if I come and I tell you what thus said the Lord, and you don't want to do it, that's on you. But guess what? I'm not going to be in court required of that, because I can deliver my own soul. I done been obedient and not rebellious, and I done came and told you what thus said the Lord. Now, if you want to get an attitude, if you want to get mad, and then even if you do not even want to do it, I'm not going to get in trouble for you. I did what the Lord said. So guess what? We won't be holding hands going to hell. You are going to hold your own hand and take your own self to hell, because I done told you what the Lord said, and I done delivered my soul. The book says so. See, I'm not telling y'all nothing that the book did not say. I'm talking about the leaders that is allowing homosexuals to come into church and say it's okay. It's not okay, because the Bible says it's not. I'm talking about the leaders who is committing adultery against their wives with the parishioners in the church. I'm talking about the leaders who allow anything to go on in the church, and it's contrary to the word of God. There's a warning and a trumpet being blown out to you. It's up to you to do what thus saith the Lord. It's up to you to take heed to the warning. It ain't up to me. I'm just a messenger. And see, I got the thing in my heart. I got it in my heart that I may be able to tell you what thus said the Lord. I'm talking to all the leaders. I don't care what your title may be or what your position may be in the land. I'm talking about God is requiring some things from you. And if you do not cry loud and spare not, the blood is going to be on your hand. It's praying time. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. See, God thinks we are important to him. God thinks we are important to him. So he wants us to be corrected. For the Bible says that he chastised them that he loved. If he didn't love us, he would not tell us. See, God feels like we have a purpose in this land. God cares about us. I don't care whether you're a leader or you're not. God loves us. He said he had no delight that any of his people should perish, not even the wicked. He wants everybody to be saved and come into the fullness of his glory. God thinks we are something and somebody, and we must cry loud and we must spare not. It's prayer time. Thank you, God. Thank you, God. Thank you, Lord. The Lord thinks that we are worth saving. He thinks that we are worth keeping. He want to cleanse us. He want to keep us in his will, that we may sit on high with him. See, he got some mansions for us. And I'm striving to get to that mansion. I want to walk on the gold up there. I want to sing and lift my hand before God. Father God, I come to you on this morning, God, and I just want to thank you, God. I want to thank you for the word that you gave me for your people, Father God. I want to thank you for opening up our eyes that we may see, and opening up our ears that we may hear. Father God, in the name of Jesus, I'm asking you right now to touch every leader, Father God, in the name of Jesus, that you have called to be over your people. I'm asking you right now, Father God, that you will cover them in your blood and hide them behind your cross. I'm asking you, Lord, to put coals of fire on their tongue that it burn up everything that's not like it, God. I'm asking you right now, Father God, to stir the gifts up inside of them, Father God, and make their face like a flint and adamant, Father God, that no fiery darts can come and stimulate them, Father God. I'm asking you right now, Father God, that they be about your business, Lord. I'm asking you to put zeal in them, God, and that they would get in a hurry about your business and return unto their first love. Lord, I'm asking you to do some things in today, God, and overturn some things on today concerning your people, Father God, in the name of Jesus, that we will be holy and that we will be righteous. Father God, I'm asking you to touch right now, God. Rest, rule, and abide within the midst of your people, Father God. I'm asking you not to turn a deaf ear on today, God. But I'm asking you to allow us to stand and to stand firm, Father God. That we may preach and teach your word, Father God. That they will not go to hell, Father God. And that our hands will not have the blood on them, God. We want to be set free on today, God. We want you to raise us up on today, God. We want you to cleanse us. And we want you to wash us over, Father God. We're asking you right now, Lord, in your son Jesus' name. Amen, amen, and amen. This is Harvest Time Ministries International. Join us every Wednesday morning at 6 a.m. for prayer. And join us every Saturday at 10:30 for the Word of God. We love you on today. And remember, so do I and Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord.